Hello students, today we are going to see the topic group technology. I am Professor K. Kalidas to handle the session for you. What is group technology? It is an approach to manufacturing in which similar parts are identified and grouped together in order to take advantage of their similarities in design and production. Say, for example, in a manufacturing sector, you may get a rectangular shaped components, also a circular shaped components. So the rectangular shaped components can be machined in a set of machineries, say like shaping, and the circular components can be machined in a particular type of machineries like lathe. So now, a grouping has been done in order to take the advantage of this design and as well as the production. So this is called as the group technology. So these parts are classified into part families. So in each part family, the processing steps are going to be similar. The entire set of process is going to be similar for the entire part family. The improvement is typically achieved by organizing the production facilities into cells that specialize in production of the part family. Say, the entire lathe is forming a cell. The entire shaping is going to form a cell. So, a group of component, irrespective of the dimensions, will move to the lathe cell. Then the rectangular component as a group, it goes to the paper shape. So what is meant by part family? So a group of parts that possesses similarities in geometrical shape and size or in the processing steps used in their manufacturing. So it is the future of group technology to assemble the components or to group the components into a family. So there are always differences among the parts in a family. Means the dimensions may differ, the material may be differing. So there are always some differences among the parts of a family. But the similarities are close enough that the parts can be grouped into a family. Even though there is some difference, can be still grouped as a family. Say, for example, two parts that are identical in shape and size, but quite different in manufacturing. Say, the component one, the component A and B is identical in shape and size, but still it is quite different in manufacturing because of the reason that they need nearly 10 lakh units per year in the first component and only 100 per year in the second component. So even though there are some parts, say 10 parts are available, they are different in shape but quite similar to manufacturing also. So there is a reverse possibility also. So it is having some different shape and size, but manufacturing procedure remains common. Say like all parts are machined from cylindrical stroke by turning, and some parts require only drilling or milling similar. So two aspects. One is with respect to design, and our one with respect to manufacturing. So how to identify them? So simply we can go for a visual inspection. So by seeing the parts or photos of the parts, just I can categorize them into a family. Or production flow analysis. I know how I am going to get my final product. So depend on my flow analysis, I'm going to group them. And third one is part classification coding system. So it's a system which is adapted for all kinds of components. So a coding will be given for a component. So when you see that coding, you can identify what is the shape of the component, what is the size of the component, what is the material of the component. Everything can be found using that classification code. So again, this classification is done on two bases generally. So part design attribute and as well as part manufacturing attribute. And few parts, again, it can fall on both the categories also. So what are the design attributes and what are the manufacturing attributes? So the major dimension, again, if it is a circular product, we should know what is the diameter of the component. Then basic external shape, basic internal shape, does it have any drilling or not? Length to diameter ratio, that is L by D ratio. What is the material type? What is the part function, tolerances, surface finish? So everything comes under the design category. So as far as the manufacturing category is concerned, what is the major process? What is the operation sequence? What is the batch size? What is the expected annual production? Which machine tool is going to be used and which cutting tool is going to be used? And what is the material of the component? So this comes under the manufacturing category. So structure, again, it's a monocode structure or hierarchical structure or chain type polycode structures, or it's a mixed code structures. So it means, say, hierarchical in the sense, depends on the previous code, the next code has been designed. So there is a dependency between the codes. But chain type, every code is individual of its own type. There be some mixing also. Let us see that with an example. So, few classification coding systems that is available in industries. The Optis classification system is very famous system. Then Brist, Code, Cutplan, D-class, Multi-class, Part Unlock system. So, all these are various coding system schemes. So let us see how Optis classification system works. So here we have got 9 digits. So digit 1 gives you the L by D ratio if it is a rotational product. A to B or A to C ratio in terms of a non-rotational product. Say if it's a rectangle, A, B, C indicates length, breadth and width. So you can calculate the dimensions of A by B, A by C, etc. So up to 1 to 5, you can have the digits. If the L by D ratio is less than or equal to 0.5, it is termed as 0. So similarly, it goes on up to 5. Then 6 to 9 for non-rotational components. Then shape 2 or digit 2 says, what is the main shape? So here 0, 1, 2 says, what is the external shape? Again, what are the main shapes that is being available for the particular component? You can have any name, say for example, cubic, and have hexagonal. So the main shape can be of our preference. You can do that. Then third one is internal shape element. So what is the internal shape that you are going to have? Whether it's going to be a rectangle, square, or even it's a rotational machining, like drilling or boring. Then for non-rotational also, whether then go for a boring or rotational machining. Then digit 4 is the plane surface machining. So how you are going to have the machining the plane surface. Then additional anything like poles, teeth forming, anything, heat treatments, anything can be done. So this 5 digits, again, it can be further classified with respect to some numbers that we will see. The supplementary codes will say 6 is the dimension, 7 is the material, 8 is the original shape of the raw material, 9 is the material. So digit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 plays a major role, and other things are going to be only the supplementary codes. So now, what are this digit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 indicates? So similarly, the same thing is being indicated. So digit 1 indicates the LBD ratio for rotational and ABV, ABC for non-rotational. Now the external shape we have set for digit 2. It's a smooth surface or it's a threaded surface. Grooves are taken. Anything. If others, then again you can give some numbers. Then for digit 3, again you have internal shapes. Again you have threads, grooves, all this functional cones, all this operation. Then plane surface machining. So again, external plane surface machining, external grooving, planes we have taken, all this comes. Digit 5, again pulse and gear teeth. So it's a axial pole or a radial pole. So what is the type of teeth that you are going to make? Spur gear or bevel gear, any other gear teeth. So it depends on that you are going to allocate some digit. So the first 5 digits, again, it is being classified into subcategories like this. So if I randomly say a number, say 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, you should know what is the type of component and what is the machining made externally, internally, and all the other processes. So let's take an example. So here there is a product. So the length is going to be 1.5 units. The diameter is going to be 1 unit. So first is LBD ratio. So it's 1.5. So 1.5 in a rotational component comes under the digit 1, which is 1. So it is 0.5 to 3. So it's going to be 1. Then the external shape, the rotational part that is stepped on both sides with one thread. So if the thread is there, then it is going to be 5. The internal shape, there is a hole. So you can see the diameter of the hole is 0.25. So there is a hole. So you can say, yes, hole is being indicated. So smooth part, step rad, 1 meter. So that's been a shape element. So you can take the component number as 1. Then comes, there is no plane surface machining or there is no gear holes or gears, axillary holes or gears. So it's been given as 0. So finally, I can get the code as 15100. So if you see this number, just I can map it to that particular category of allotment and I can fix the code. So in this lecture, we have seen about what is group technology, what is part family, what is part classification coding system, and what is the office classification system with an exam. Thank you.